Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about wandering spleen imaging. So before to understand about the imaging of the wandering spleen, we have to understand what is wandering spleen. So wandering spleen is an increased mobility of spleen due to abnormal ligamentous attachment, which may be congenitally absent, results in increased laxity. The long vascular vesicle predisposed to acute or chronic intermittent torsion and or infection. Most common sign symptom without torsion, we can palpable mobile mass or asymptomatic. If with torsion, patient will be present with abdominal pain and palpable mass. Other signs symptoms, it could be can be fever, vomiting plus minus bowel obstruction, pancreatitis due to pancreatic tail involvement, and bleeding varices. Demographic, B module distribution, first one is less than 1 year of age, male more than female, or certificate of one female more than male. Top differential analysis, sick as a disease, heterotaxy syndrome, lymphoma, splenic trauma, mononucleosis. In the imaging, so it can show us like absence of the normal spleen in the left upper quadrant and large spleeniform mass in mid lower abdomen with torsion, twist, hilar, vessel, pedidema, and ascites. In CT, we can see globally decreased splenic enhancement plus minor residual capsular rim enhancement in ultrasound hypovascular heterogeneous splenic parenchyma in case of wandering spleen with torsion. So this is the ultrasound image in with color Doppler in a newborn with a palpable abdominal mass, so the spleeniform mass in the mid lower left abdomen with heterogeneous internal ecotension. No internal vascular flow is seen in the mass. Mild ascites is noted. A normal spleen was not found in the left upper quadrant. And this is the contrasting hand CT of the same patient. So, diminished enhancement of the spleeniform left abdominal mass, a torsion, and infarcted wandering spleen was surgically removed. This is the contrasting hand CT in a 9-year-old patient with abdominal pain. And the story of repair, custom crisis, so inferiorly displaced and large and non-enhancing spleen in the mid to lower left abdomen, consistent with splenic torsion. There is a subtle residual rim of capsular enhancement. No splenic tissue is seen in the left upper quadrant. Again, this is the contrastant CT in the same patient, so a torch non-enhancing spleen. And this is the AP radiograph in the 18 months or patient with pushiness of an abdominal distension show absence of normal splenic shadow in the abdominal right upper quadrant. This displays a bulges by an enlarged spleniformis in the left abdomen. Contrast enhanced CT in the same patient, so no enhancement of the displaced and abnormally rotated enlarged spleen consistent with torsion and ischemia infarction. The spleen was freely mobile and enlarged in omentum at surgery. This is the contrast enhancement in a 16 years old girl with abdominal pain, so markedly enlarged and inferior medially displaced spleen with normal enhancement. Again, a contrast enhanced CT in the same patient, so a very elongated spleen vascular pedicle contain numerous dilated veins. A sphere configuration of the pedicle was noted on serial axial image. No normal splenic ligaments attachment were found at surgery. Typical of wandering spleen at pathology, the spleen was congested but not infected. Treatment. Without infection, the torsion plus splenopexy. With infection, splenectomy, vaccination, antibiotic prophylaxis for splenia, plus minus gastropexia to prevent a rare gastric valvulus. Thank you.